Welcome! You're watching the Thrift Store Rundown, where for the rest of September, we're bringing you back to school with the stars by doing what we've been happy to do for several years now. Bring Hollywood to the classroom on a budget. Any classroom, be it on dry land or, in this case, under the sea with the Wonder Pets. You guys saw the Wonder Pets, right, on the junior? A staple of my childhood TV viewing habits, as well as almost everybody else's. What's not to like about three adorable baby animal superheroes? Lily the guinea pig, Tuck the turtle, and Ming the duckling, traveling around in their flyboat, helping baby animals in distress around the world. Or in this case, under the world. Under the sea. This is the after-school book. It's number 3 in a series of Wonder Pets kids books. I picked it up for 25% off 99 cents, so like 74 cents. Out of retail prices of $3.99 in the US, $4.99 in Canada. This particular story was adapted by Sascha Paladino from his or her television screenplay with illustrations by the Little Airplane Productions storyboard team, principally Michael Scanlon. It's a Simon's Sister publication, and it goes a little something like this if you haven't seen the original episode. The Wonder Pets in their classroom get a distress call from a baby blowfish who's scared to go to school. Okay, simple mission for the Wonder Pets, but they haven't really gone underwater before, so they adapt their flyboat to become a fly sub, so that they can go under the ocean. I'll spare you my singing of their official credo, their theme song, but when they get to the bottom of the sea, they head to the baby blowfish's preschool, and they try to ease his or her pain. There are all sorts of fun activities to do at Fish preschool without this becoming a Finding Nemo-like story. There's suckle time, there's lunch time, there's play time, etc. And lots of times to learn and to make new friends, which baby blowfish does, expertly. Then things get serious, as Ming would say, when the mama blowfish has to leave for the day. Then they ease baby blowfish's fear with a little song. If I can go back to that, I think we skipped that. Wherever you are, whatever you do, so always, always come back for you. And indeed, after a good day at school, baby blowfish's mama does come back, easing her fears even more. For their efforts in accompanying baby blowfish to her first day of preschool, the Wonder Pets get rewarded with celery, this time with raisins. There you go. A baby blowfish is really nervous about the first day of school, but with the help of Liddy, Tuck, and Ming Ming, she realizes there's no reason to be afraid. School is fun. Do you want more Wonder Pet books? Well, you get Goodnight Wonder Pets, Join the Circus, and the Wonder Pets Save the Bengal Tiger. They're available at your favorite store, and most certainly at your favorite thrift store, in this case. If you want a couple of behind-the-scenes tidbits, well, one of the influencers of record around here, Tila Dunn, was the voice of Tuck the Turtle. And don't get me started on the show's music. Aside from its theme and all its various songs, there's nothing like having a 10-person orchestra perform a myriad of elements to really enhance the show's awesomeness. The show won 5 Emmys for its music for a reason, folks, because it's awesome. Anyway, other than all that, it's a simple, cute story that gets all 5 claps. And you know, here on dry land, it's never this easy to ease any kid's fears of going to school for the first time or heading back to school during September. But you know what? That's where we all gotta work together. Parents and non-parents and kids and, well, youngsters of all ages. When you guys work together, you got the right stuff. And hopefully you'll include this in that stuff, because I think this can help out quite a bit. Go Wonder Pets!
Quiet!
Thanks for watching! Check out more TSR by clicking on another awesome review like this one, top left, and be sure to subscribe by clicking top right! Until next time, I'll catch you on the Thrift Side!